We will continue to offer paper versions of the student engagement worksheets that go with our science videos. But we know that paper takes a lot of time, making copies, handing them out, grading them, entering grades into gradebooks, and returning them to students. Beginning this month, we offer all science video engagement worksheets in several electronic formats. Students can complete these worksheets at home while watching a science video that you assign and have the results automatically sent to your gradebook or other dataset. We also offer answers in Google Slides, which you can use online or downloaded as a Microsoft PowerPoint for in-class teaching or to send to students as a future resource. In addition to saving you time, electronic formats give students immediate feedback after they submit their answers, and many include detailed explanations. This can help students learn from their mistakes while the content is still fresh. We will review these formats in this video. If you work in a school that uses one of these formats already, please use the timestamps in the description to skip to that part of the timeline for this video. We'll start with Google Forms. This can work with Google Classroom, but also works as a standalone service with a personal Google Drive account, which is free. If you don't have Google Classroom, you can send an email to students, and when they click on the link, they will be taken to this worksheet with instructions on how to view the video and how to complete the worksheet. The worksheet includes the video that they can view on this tab, or in a larger tab so they can see the timestamps to jump to a specific question. When ready to answer the questions, the students enter their names and answers for each question. Once done, the students submit their answers, which will be sent back to the form, and will organize everyone's results. If you permit, students can see their scores after they submit the worksheet. That way, they can then learn from their mistakes while the material is still fresh. Now let's review how you can see the results. By clicking on the form of interest, you can click on the responses tab to see a summary of their scores. You can scroll down to see how many students got each question correct. This feature may be useful for updating a lesson plan, especially if you teach the lesson the day after the students have watched the corresponding introductory science video at home. Although you can use the other tabs to review individual student responses, it may be more efficient to create a worksheet based on these results, which you may then sort according to the student's name. You can then see their summary scores and individual responses. This sheet is then saved next to the form. If you have Google Classroom, you may have these scores imported into Google Classroom for each student, so they will be in your gradebook. At any time, you may edit your copy of the form. For example, if you want to modify a question, answer, or explanation, you have full access to do that, since this is your personal copy of the form. Likewise, you can go to the Settings tab and decide which options are enabled. For example, if you want to verify the identity of each student, then they will need to sign in with their Google account. You can assign the form to your students by clicking the Send button. Although you could enter email addresses, this may fail for some emails that are not Gmail accounts. So we suggest that you copy the link then send this in an email to your class roster. You can assign this form within Google Classroom if you import it into Google Classroom. To get a copy of a form, scroll down until you get to the section which describes the shared drive of Google Forms. Then click on that link when you're signed into your Google Drive. Next, right-click the mouse on a form you want to copy. After the copying is complete, you can then view your personal copy when you click on the My Drive icon. These are the forms you will modify if you wish, and the ones you will use to send to your students. Microsoft also has forms that you can use if you have a Microsoft 365 account. As with the Google Forms, when students receive emails from a teacher, it will have a link which the students can click and will take them to a form that explains how to complete the worksheet and how to view the video. Microsoft Forms also have the option to give feedback to students with the correct answers right after they have entered their results, plus explanations as to why those are the correct answers. When you view summary results, you can see which questions were most problematic. You may view individual results by clicking here, but it is often more efficient to view these as a spreadsheet. Emails will not be collected from the students unless they have an email account in your network. Unlike Google Forms, Microsoft Forms automatically number each question, so we had to put the student's name last, so the video's timestamps would still correlate with the question numbers. But if you wish to see the student's name adjacent to the score, you can highlight the columns between them and hide those columns. Prior to sending a Microsoft form, go to Settings and ensure that there is a check in the box to accept responses. To send a form to students, click the button called Collect Responses. If students have emails in your network, then you can paste a classroom roster here. But if they don't have network emails, then you can copy the form's link to your clipboard and paste that into an email. Then, paste the classroom roster emails into the recipient line. As with Google Forms, you may edit any Microsoft Form question, answers, and feedback as you wish by typing in those respective boxes. To get your personal copy of a Microsoft Form, go to the Worksheet of Interest, then to the section which specifies the Microsoft Form. When you click on the link, you will be taken to a page and given the option to duplicate it. After you duplicate it, the form will appear in your Forms folder. Easel is an interactive tool that is part of the website called Teachers Pay Teachers. Easel offers activities and assessments. This is an example of an activity based on one of our videos. After receiving an assignment from you, the student enters responses to each question and can then get immediate feedback, though without explanations to those questions. Once you add an activity or assessment to your collection, you may customize it by editing these slides. This is an example of an Easel assessment. Unlike the activity, it does not contain the video since it is like a quiz. The student can get immediate feedback after answering a question. We have made links in the description to videos about how Easel can be used alone or with other learning management systems like Google Classroom. As with the activity, for your copy, you may edit each question, response options, and when answer is correct. That way, your students are seeing what you want them to. To get a copy of an Easel activity or assessment that we've made, go to the Worksheet of Interest, then click on the link for the Easel listing. Once there, you can click on the View Files button, which will let you view or assign the listing after you sign into the website. Newer listings may not yet be in our multi-worksheet document, so you can access those from our shop on Teachers Pay Teachers. Since some worksheet formats do not allow the student to see full explanations, we have made a Google slide presentation for each worksheet, which you may use during class or send to students. The video is embedded into the slide presentation, and if you hover over the timeline, you can find part of the video that contains the answer to each question, so that you may then click on that. During a slides presentation, you can press the forward arrow to make an answer appear and go to the next slide. That way, you control the speed of the pace. As with our other products, you may edit your copy of the slides in any way. You may also download this from your Google Drive as a PowerPoint file, which you can use for presentations if you prefer or email to your students. Alternatively, you can share your link to your copy of the Google Slides with your students. To get any slide presentation we have made, go to a topic of interest, then scroll to the section with the link to the share folder. While signed into your Google Drive, click on the link to the shared folder, then right-click on any file you wish or select all of them, then choose Copy. Once the file or files are copied, you can view these in your Google Drive by clicking on the My Drive icon. If your school has a learning management system, then you're welcome to import the worksheet questions into your system. You'll need to use a simple text app. On a Windows computer, we suggest Microsoft's Notepad, which you can find from your app list as illustrated here. For example, if your school uses Blackboard, you would go to a worksheet of interest, then scroll to the section for Blackboard, then highlight the text, copy it. Open a simple text app like Microsoft's Notepad and paste the contents. Please note that although the formatting may seem incorrect in the Word document, it is tab formatted per Blackboard specifications, as you can see when we widen the window, so we suggest you do not reformat this. Then save the document with a TXT extension and import it into Blackboard. We have left the video's link in plain text in case you wish to include that with the assignment. If your school uses Canvas and you want to import a worksheet, then you would find that worksheet. Scroll to the section for Canvas, copy the text, paste it into Notepad, and save it with the TXT extension. You may copy and paste the video's link if you wish to include that in the assignment. This is also the import format for Respondus 4.0, which you can use to convert into many other formats. If your school uses Moodle and you want to import a worksheet, then you would find that worksheet, scroll to the section for Moodle, copy the text, paste it into Notepad, and save it with the TXT extension. Then import this into Moodle. You may copy and paste the video's link if you wish to include that in the assignment. We hope you find one or more of these worksheet options works with your teaching style and saves you time. We also hope that using electronic worksheets will eliminate a common excuse for not completing an assignment on time. Thanks for your attention.